dear students, as we all know, now we are going through a tough time. I hope we shall overcome the situation very soon. Okay, so today onwards we are starting our physics lesson, and our first lesson is motion. Okay, in everyday life we see some objects at rest, some others are in motion. Okay, some object at rest, others are in motion. For example, birds are flying, water flowing, then planets, stars, galaxies are moving, and blood circulates through our body. All these are example for motion. Okay, so we often perceive an object to be in motion when its position changes with the time. Okay, what is it? An object to be in motion when its position changes with the time. Okay, we often perceive an object to be in motion when its position changes with the time. Okay, then most motion are complex. Most motions are complex. Clear? Sometimes some objects may move in straight line. Some others take circular path, some may rotate, and few others vibrate. Okay, some object moves in straight line. Some others take circular path. Then some others rotate, and some others vibrate. Okay, all these are examples for different kinds of motion. Okay, in this chapter we are learning to describe motion in a straight line. In this chapter we learn to describe motion in straight line. Okay, motion in straight line. You may hear about one dimensional motion, two dimensional motion, and three dimensional motion. That is one dimensional, 1D motion, 2D, two-dimensional motion, and three-dimensional motion. Nowadays, you may also hear about 4D and 8D. Okay, then what is mean by one-dimensional motion? One-dimensional motion is nothing but it is straight-line motion. Okay, one-dimensional motion is nothing but it is straight-line motion. Okay. What is meant by 2D motion? Two-dimensional motion means motion along a plane. What is meant by plane? The surface of my palm is an example for plane. And the surface of this whiteboard is an example for plane. Tabletop, the floor, all these are examples for plane. Okay. Such motion are called a two-dimensional motion. Then, what is meant by three-dimensional motion? It is the motion in space. Motion in space, that is in air. In one-dimensional motion, suppose that an ant is moving along a thread. It is the best example for one-dimensional motion or straight-line motion. Clear? Then two-dimensional motion. Suppose an ant is moving on my palm top. in this plane. This is the best example for two dimensional motion. Then three dimensional motion, birds flying and the takeoff of aeroplane and the hydrogen balloon freely moving through the air, all these are examples for three dimensional motion. Okay, in this chapter we are only dealing with the one dimensional motion or straight line motion. Clear? So in this chapter we learn to describe motion in a straight line. It's clear? To describe motion of an object, it is very important to locate the position of an object. Okay. To describe motion of an object. It is very important to locate the position of the object. It is very important to locate the position of the object. Clear? So, to describe motion of an object, it is very important to locate the position of an object. We usually locate an object by specifying a reference point. Reference point. Okay, then what is mean by reference point? Okay, we can learn it with an example. This is the example. A school in a village is located 2 kilometers north of railway station. Clear? This is our example. A school in a village is located 2 kilometers north from railway station. So here we need to locate the position of school. We located the position of school with respect to railway station. So in this example, railway station is the reference point. Clear? For our convenience, we can choose any other point. Suppose if there is a church near this school, so we can choose church as the reference point. Clear? So railway station is very popular place, so it is very easy to take it as a reference point. Clear? So to locate an object, we need to specify a reference point. That particular reference point is called origin. Clear? To locate an object, we need to specify a reference point. That reference point is called the origin. Clear? To locate position, position of an object, we need to specify a reference point. That particular reference point is called origin. Okay. Is it clear? So today we discussed about the term motion. motion and different kinds of motion. And the main important point here is reference point or origin. Okay. I hope you understood my class, and there is a homework for you. Please note down your homework. Here we took an example to locate school. So your homework is locate your house like this. By using a reference point, locate your house, the position of your house. That is your homework. So please do it. And I hope you understood the class. And thank you. We can continue in the next class.